After hearing these words, a person needs to succeed in life step by step, but he still has lot of weaknesses inside. So now he tries to hide all his weaknesses under the cover of Dhamma he had just listened to. Is it right or wrong? It has both good and bad aspects. The good aspect is, although he has many weaknesses, he has a teacher to follow and correct himself. The bad side of it is, although he has a teacher and a Dhamma to follow, the weaknesses somehow invade himself. We need to be prepared for both. Although we have prepared ourselves for both outcomes, we should not allow our selfish thoughts to be in lead. What does it mean? We all like to make habits and get ourselves involved into those habits and live a life full of habits. To die and reborn into a life full of habits again. Now, we have listened to the words to free ourselves from this cycle. It is easy to listen but difficult to practice. Our mind hardly allows us to practice the opposite. But we need to tell our mind that if we do not practice it now, a time will definitely come to pay for it. So, before that, I need to identify and address my weaknesses. Your mind always hurts you. You don't accept it. You try to live with the thoughts which mind generates without accepting the reality behind. That brings you sadness and frustration. Now we have to identify our weaknesses and go deep inside those. But when we start to go deep inside your mind to identify your weaknesses, the mind tries to cover those. To have a better understanding of our mind, we need to uncover those weaknesses and analyze openly. When we become more open, the world starts to criticize us. The mind doesn't like to be criticized because criticism always drives yourself to a new beginning. Mind prefers to lead a monotonous life, tasting old, stale stories. Monotonous life doesn't bring you peace. Instead, it makes you tired and unhappy. If one wants to make himself free from this, he needs to understand and then change his mind gradually. After we have listened to these great words, two things start to act within us. One is which we knew from the beginning, and the other one is what we just learned. If one keeps his old knowledge aside and starts to live with what he had just heard, he's going to succeed in life. It's your untamed mind which mislead you. Your untamed mind always does injustice for you. Now, we have to determine to make ourselves worthy. At the end, for that we should have practiced these words in our day-to-day life, understanding our weaknesses.